As long as we can remember that a percent is a number compared to 100, converting fractions to percentages should be a fairly straightforward process, even if we can't easily write the given fraction as an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 100. For example, for 3/8, it's not easy to recognize what we have to multiply 8 by to obtain 100. And therefore, let's go ahead and divide 3 by 8 to convert to a decimal. 3 divided by 8 is equal to 0.375. And now we'll write the decimal in fraction form with a denominator of 1. Recall we can always write a decimal in fraction form with a denominator of 1. And now if we write this fraction as an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 100, we can easily determine the percentage. And of course, 1 times 100 is equal to 100. And therefore, to write an equivalent fraction with a denominator of 100, we multiply both the numerator and denominator by 100. 0.375 times 100 is 37.5. And of course, 1 times 100 equals 100. 3/8 equals 37.5 divided by 100, which equals 37.5%. This process always works. And it also explains why the shortcut to go from a decimal to a percent is to multiply by 100 and add a percent sign. But hopefully showing this work helps explain that shortcut rule. Next, we have 22 fifteenths. We'll first convert to a decimal by dividing 22 by 15. In this case, we get a repeating decimal, 1.466 with the 6 repeating. We write this as a fraction with a denominator of 1. Recall, because the 6 is repeating, we can write this as 1.46 with a bar over only the 6 divided by 1. And now to write this as an equivalent fraction with the denominator of 100, again, we multiply the numerator and denominator by 100. 1.46 repeating times 100 is equal to 146.6 repeating, and 1 times 100 is 100, indicating 22 fifteenths equals 146.6 repeating percent. I hope you found this helpful.